Hey folks, it's Nick Granville. Welcome to Guitar Daily. I thought today I'd break down the Larry Carlton solo with Steely Dan, one of my favourite all-time solos on the tune Kid Charlemagne. So I thought today, yeah, let's look at it and let's find some of the key licks that I like. So you just heard the solo there. I've played this a bunch. I've been playing this since I was about 15, 16 years old, and I played it at the Vertex booth with Mason for a few years ago at the NAMM show, so I kind of got it brushed back up for that, and then since I learned it for that, I was like, oh, well, I might as well just keep playing it, so it's kind of become one that I use a little bit to work on my playing, and I've stolen a bunch of licks from it, so I thought I'd talk about that today, and I'll show you some of the ones that most captured my imagination, and I put them in my own playing. First one, it works over a D chord. So the cool thing with this, starts on the fifth. It's a very unusual way of playing. I would never have thought to do something like this. If I want to put to the key of G, right, I go to the fifth. And the cool thing I found is just kind of take it through the chord changes. That takes us up the octave, right? And then once you can do that, you can put it in a few different keys and you can take it through all the chord changes like I just did, that lick will become part of your vocabulary. What I find is usually a lick like that, if I just keep doing it over and over again, and I keep trying to put it into other keys and put it in other songs, to start with, it's like in my practice, it's going to sound very contrived, and that's fine. But then after a while, it just becomes a very natural thing that sounds like it'll come out in a solo one time and I'll be like, oh, that was that lick I was working on. I stole that from Larry Carlton. As I stole a lot of things from Larry Carlton. Great guitar player. So here's another one. Now, I've always enjoyed kind of putting a rake across that. So I'm actually raking across the string. Right, and that's over a C major 7 chord. So it bends up to the 7th. That's the way I would look at it, right? So if I wanted a D in the key of D, there's my D note. I'm going to bend up to that note. So now I probably, if I was playing that lick, I probably would have, myself, would have gone. But he went. Which is really cool, right? The key of G, right? I know it starts on the 6th and bends up to the 7th. If I was going to take it through all the chord changes again and put it into other keys. So that'd be the second one. Third one. It's got to be one of my favorite licks. So the way I'd look at that is the chord's in E, essentially E minor, D over E, and then it goes to an A minor. So it's really a 5-chord lick, something you play across a 5-chord of some sort. Minor or dominant would work over a sharp 9-chord really well, and I do use it in that instance. But it starts from the 5th of the 5-chord, right? So if I know I'm going to go, say, an A7 to a D minor, to put it in another key, right? The 5th of A is E. Right, and that takes me to that key. Say I wanted it in the key of G. Well, that's going to be down one. Right, and I'll put them in all keys and of course try and take them through chord changes. That works really well, but that's a really cool lick. I like that one. Well, this next lick is a really cool one over a major chord. Sounds a little bit country, right? But it starts again. I know it's an F, it starts from the fifth. So say I wanted the key at A. Key of D. Put it back to the original key. Pretty cool lick. Ah, this is probably is my favorite lick of all of them. Right, and that's over a B flat 7 sharp 11 chord. Right. Right, the Lydian dominant sound, right? So for me, I know it starts on the third, right? So if I want to move that to G. Pretty cool. Kind of, I suspect he was thinking like an A7. Over G. Now resolving to that, but it's kind of all in contained in there. If I want to put it the key of E, find the third. However you want to play it. But that's another cool lick that I use. I put that one in my, that's in my playing. Now this one, it's missing a couple of notes on the notation, but you'll get it. It's kind of an unusual one because it's going from E minor to C. Right, but the takeaway from that for me is if I want to put that all into E minor, I might not necessarily go from E minor to C7. And I might even actually change another note in there and go. You see, I can sort of adapt it. That would be the original, but putting it to another key. Alright, that's essentially putting it in A minor. This is an easy lick because it starts on the root note. Moves into that C7 sound pretty clearly. Like actually even early, right? And here we're really implying C. It's almost like you went half a bar early into the C7, and that's really cool because it's sort of you're setting up the chord that's about to happen. Put it into A. Right, and then I just put my own thing on the end, right? All of a sudden what I've done is I've taken something that's very Larry Carlton and made it my own. And that's kind of how these licks and vocabulary things work. You start off with borrowing them from someone else and you sort of play them over and over, and you know, and like I said, I just keep practicing them, moving them into other keys, putting them through chord changes. Next thing you know, they come out naturally. And when they come out naturally, usually they don't sound anything like the original. And it's crazy, when I look back on licks after years and years and years later, I go, oh, maybe I should go and check out the source again. And I go and check out the source of where I got the lick from, and it sounds nothing like the thing I had. Maybe I've changed some slides, some bends, some whatever, and it sort of has become my vocabulary. I always find it funny. I have had a few students over the years and different musicians I've worked with who have said, oh man, you sound just like John Scofield. Or when I was younger, I used to get, you know, you sound just like Robin Ford. And when I was even younger still, they used to call me the White George Benson. When I was at music schools, I was so into George Benson. And they used to call me the White George Benson because apparently I sounded just like George Benson. You know, the crazy thing is I never sounded like George Benson. I never sounded like Robin Ford, and I definitely don't sound like John Scofield. You know, I mean, I'm influenced by those guys. Don't get me wrong. I love their playing. I've stolen heaps of licks from them, but the licks have kind of become my own now. And I think sometimes when people hear a bit of distortion on a sound, yeah, they go, oh, distorted guitar playing bebop-ish things. They go, John Scofield. There's kind of more to it than that. Do you know what I mean? But anyway, there's some licks that I thought I'd go over today from the Kid Charlemagne solo. The transcription, if you have a look around online, you can find it easily for the whole solo. Learn it up. Get it under your fingers. Take the licks from it. I haven't really done that much transcribing. I've done a bit. I did probably most when I was at music school. Nowadays, I just transcribe, instead of transcribing whole solos, I'll just grab the bits I want nowadays, just because of time pressures. But also, I don't need to look at it so much from the whole structure anymore. I just want to grab the bits I want to grab. So, and that's what I've done with this particular solo. I learnt the whole thing, I grab the bits I want to grab, and I make them part of my playing. If you like what I've discussed today, please subscribe. My subscriber count is growing, and I really appreciate everybody being a part of this. I've done 100 episodes every day on YouTube. I know, it's amazing, I can't believe it myself. And I'll continue to do this and do some breakdowns of classic songs. I thought maybe Hotel California might be a good one, so let me know if you like that. Or even I did a short of the solo from Another Brick in the Wall, so maybe that's a good one that I could cover. I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comments below. But again, thanks so much for watching. That's the main thing, is that you're here checking this out. And I will see you tomorrow. Cheers.